हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम शरभ अग्रवाल, मेंबर ऑफ कॉम्पिटिटिव प्रोग्रामिंग ग्रुप कॉप्स आईआईटी बीएचयू। इन दिस वीडियो आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट वेरियस स्ट्रिंग एल्गोरिथम्स विच इंक्लूड स्ट्रिंग हैशिंग एंड इट्स एप्लीकेशंस, फॉलोड बाय द प्रीफिक्स फंक्शन और जेड फंक्शन एंड देन केएमपी एल्गोरिथम। नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट विद स्ट्रिंग हैशिंग। कंपेयरिंग टू स्ट्रिंग्स, दैट इज चेकिंग वेदर दे आर इक्वल और नॉट। The brute force way of doing this is compare both these strings letter by letter. That is, first compare first character. If they are equal, move on to the second character. If second character is also equal, then move on to third and so on. If all the characters are equal, then if the length of the string is equal, then the strings are also equal. So net time complexity is minimum of the length of the strings. Now, the efficient way of calculating this is, what if we convert each string into an integer and then compare those integers instead of the whole string? Then comparing these two strings will be an O of 1 operation, because we have to compare two integers rather than the two strings. For this conversion, we need a so-called hash function and a corresponding hash value. So what are this hash function and hash value? A hash value of a string is a number which is calculated from the characters of the string. It is unique for every string, and if two hash values are same, we will say that the strings are also equal. Now, the function which we will use to calculate this hash value is called a hash function. The calculation of the hash of a string. Suppose there is a string S, S1, S2, S3 till Sn. These are the characters of the string, and suppose the hash function is the sum of the characters in S, that is, the hash value will be sum of the value of each character in S. Now, in general, we will assign a particular value to every character, that is, A is assigned 1, B is assigned 2, so on till Z is assigned 26. This will be the standard assignment for the whole video. Now, take two strings ABC and AAD. The hash value of this string using some hash function will be 1 plus 2 plus 3, as 1 has value, A has value 1, B has value 2 and C has value 3. So they sum up to 6. Similarly, the string AAD will have hash value 6. Now what is this? The two strings are different, but the hash value are coming out to the same. This is what is known as collision. So what is collision? A collision occurs when two different strings evaluate to the same hash. This is the problem of string hashing. Now the usual way to implement string hashing is polynomial rolling hash function. Now in this method, we will calculate hash of a string as S of 0, that is first character, plus S of 1 into P, the second character into P, plus S of 2 into P square, so on till S of n minus 1 into p key power n minus 1, and we will calculate whole modulo n. You can see that this is zero based indexing like a normal string is. So the above equation can be represented mathematically using this equation, where n is the length of the string, m and p are some positive numbers, and we are choosing these positive numbers according to our convenience. Now it is reasonable to make p a prime number roughly equal to the number of characters in the input alphabet. That is, if the input is only lowercase English alphabets, then the p is equal to 31 is a good choice, because 31 is nearby 26. Now the implementation code. This is the function compute hash, which will return a long value of hash. It is taking a string S as an argument. Now the two variables M and P as values 31 and 10 key power 9 plus 9. The hash value is the final value of the hash. Initially it is 0. This P power is the power of P which is multiplied in each index. For example, in this equation, the P power for 0th index is 1. For first index it is P. For second index it is p square, so on till n minus 1 index that is p की पावर n माइनस वन. सो फॉर एवरी कैरेक्टर इन द स्ट्रिंग s, द हैश वैल्यू इज कैलकुलेटेड एज द प्रीवियसली कैलकुलेटेड हैश वैल्यू प्लस द वैल्यू ऑफ द कैरेक्टर इनटू p पावर मॉड्यूलो m, एंड द p पावर इज मल्टीप्लाइड बाय p आफ्टर ईच इटरेशन एज शोन इन द अबव इक्वेशन. फाइनली द हैश वैल्यू इज रिटर्न. नाउ द कोलिजन मस्ट बी रिड्यूस्ड सो एज द आंसर इज प्रॉपरली कैलकुलेटेड. द फर्स्ट मेथड इज वी शुड कीप m such that m into m doesn't result in overflow. Now, we know that the maximum long integer value in C++ can be around 9 into 10 to the power 18. So, the appropriate choice of m such that m doesn't overflow as well as it is maximum integer possible can be around 10 to the power 9. So, the standard value is 10 to the power 9 plus 9. Now, the second method is we can just compute two different hashes for each string. That is, rather than the single hashing, we can use double hashing or triple hashing, in which we will be using two different p or two different m or both. So, if the two strings have the same hash value according to first hashing, then we will compare them with second hashing, and if they are still equal, then it is very less chance that the collision still occurs. So, this is a very nice method. Now, the main part, applications of hashing. The first application is calculating hash value of any substring in O of 1. And this is done after some pre-calculation, which is to construct an array hash such that hash of k contains the hash value of the prefix of the string till k. So, this can be implemented quite easily. We will see its implementation in the next part. Now, the hash of a substring from I to j is equal to s of I plus s of I plus 1 into p, so on till s of j into p ki power j minus I whole mod m. It can be mathematically represented as the following summation, which is this. This is the standard definition of hash of a string. Now, for computing this value, we will consider this difference between hash of substring, basically prefix substring till j minus hash of prefix substring till I minus 1, and these two values are already calculated in this array. So we will take its difference in O of 1 time, and then we will divide it by p key power I to make it equal to the equation this. For any substring from I to j, the hash of prefix till j minus hash of prefix till I minus 1 will be equal to s of I into p key power I plus s of I plus 1 into p key power I plus 1, so on till s of j into p key power j. So, coming back here, we have to divide p key power I in this equation to frame our answer. So, rather than dividing it by p key power I, we will multiply it by modular multiplicative inverse of p key power I. This is the basic modular arithmetic. You must have studied it already. So, after this computation, the hash of any substring can be calculated in O of 1 time. Now, representing it in another form, multiplying this equation by p key power I, we will get this equation. That is, hash of a substring from I to j into p key power I is equal to this summation. And this summation is equal to hash of string of prefix till j minus hash of string of prefix till I minus 1 whole mod m. In question, we will be given a string and we have to check whether a substring is equal to that string or not. So, basically we have to compare two strings. So, rather than dividing this equation by p key power I, we can multiply p key power I in the given string and compare the two values. If they are coming out to be equal, then we will say, okay, the strings are same. Similarly, we have to compare two substrings. Suppose one has to be multiplied by p key power I and other has to be multiplied by p key power j. Then if I is less than j, then we will multiply the first hash by p key power j minus i, so that the power of p is equal for both these strings. Now, the hash value will be same if the strings are equal, Otherwise, if the hash value is not the same, then they are different. So in this way, we can calculate the hash value of any substring and compare them as well. Now the second implementation, Rabin-Karp algorithm for string matching. The problem statement is, given two strings, a pattern S and a text T, determine if the pattern appears in the text, and if it does, enumerate all the occurrences in basically in O of n time, where n is the length of the largest string. So for this, we will calculate the hash value of the string S as well as the hash value of text T, and we will store the all the hash of the prefix string in an array as we have done it earlier. Now we will compare all the substrings of length as equal to the string S in the text T and check whether it is equal to string S or not. Now each comparison can be performed in O of 1, as we have seen it here, that we can perform it in O of 1, and comparing all the strings of length equal to as a pattern S will be O of n. So net complexity is O of n only. Exactly, its net complexity is O of mod S plus mod T, where mod S and mod T are the length of the strings S and T. Now the implementation code. So arguments are string S and string T. P and M are said to be 31 and 10 to the power 9 plus 9. Capital S is size of the string S and capital T is size of string T. This is the pre-calculation where P power of I is basically P key power I. Now the second pre-calculation is hash value of all the substrings. So we have calculated it using this. H of I plus 1 is H of I plus the value of the current index into P power of I. So this is a normal method, and this H underscore S will be the hash value of the string S. So we have calculated it, and now vector int occurrences, it will be the vector which will contain the indexes where the string S is exactly same as the substring in T. So we will store the starting index in the T. Now the char H, it will be the hash value of the substring of length S and starting from index I. So this is the H of I plus S minus H of I modulo M, and we are doing plus M, it is basic modular arithmetic. Now multiplying it by power, that is P power of I, we will compare the H of S into P key power I with the original substring hash, and if they are equal, then we will say that both strings are equal, and occurrences dot pushback I will represent that we will push back the index of the matched substring, and finally the vector will be returned, and so we will get all the indexes starting from which the substring of T is equal to the string S. So this is the application. There are further applications like calculating the number of different substrings, calculating the number of palindromic strings, and search for duplicate strings in an array of strings. You can try it yourself. Now, this is a very important note. Using hashing will not be 100% deterministically correct, because two complete different strings might have the same hash. That is, the chance of collision is always there. So it is advisable to minimize the use of hashing and apply other string algorithms which we are going to use later. Now here comes the second string algorithm, the prefix function. The introduction part. Suppose you are given a string S of length n. The prefix function will be an array of length n and is denoted by pi. So the pi of I will contain the length of the longest proper prefix of the substring, which is also a suffix of the substring. So it will contain the length of the longest string, which are same as suffix as well as prefix. Now consider the whole string from 0 to I. So it will be prefix of the string S as well as the suffix of the string S. So the maximum answer is always equal to the length of the substring. But here we have mentioned that we will take only proper prefix. So a proper prefix of a string is a prefix that is not equal to the string itself. By definition, pi of 0 is equal to 0, because string of one length has no proper prefix. Here comes an example. Suppose a string is ABCACBD. Now, pi of 0 is 0. Pi of 1, it is equal to 0 because none of the prefix is equal to the suffix. Now, pi of 2, that is C, none of the prefix is equal to suffix, so answer is 0. Now, pi of 3, A is the suffix and A is the prefix. It is the maximum length which is equal, so answer is 1. Consider pi of 4. Now, AB is the suffix and AB is also the prefix. 2 length is the maximum possible. So, the answer is 2. Consider here. Now, ABC, it is a 3 length suffix as well as the prefix is ABC. So, the pi of 5 will be equal to 3. You can check that more than 3 answer is not possible. Similarly, pi of 6 will be 0 and so on. Now, here comes the implementation part. First, naive algorithm. The basic idea is iterate over all I and calculate pi of I for each iteration. Now, for calculating pi of I, we will check all possible lengths such that the prefix is equal to suffix. For each comparison, it will take O of n time and we will perform such comparisons for I times. So, the net complexity is O of n cube. Now, here comes the implementation part. We will iterate from 0 to n minus 1 length. Now, for calculating pi of I, suppose the length of the common prefix and suffix is equal to k. So, the k can vary from 0 to I. And for checking whether they are equal or not, that is the suffix and prefix are equal or not, we will check whether the substring from 0 to k is equal to substring from I minus k plus 1 to k. If they are equal, then we will assign pi of I is equal to k. So, the total implementation is n cube. Now, improved algorithm. First, optimization. The observation which we are making is that pi of I plus 1 is always less than equal to pi of I plus 1. That is, the values of the prefix function can only increase by at most 1. This is a very important observation. So, here comes the proof. Suppose we assume that pi of I plus 1 is greater than pi of I plus 1. We will prove it by contradiction. So, if it is possible, then there is a suffix ending in position I plus 1 with length pi of I. Suppose we remove one character from this pi of I plus 1, then we will get the suffix ending in position I whose length will be equal to pi of I plus 1 minus 1 and it will also be the prefix and will be equal. So, the pi of I should be equal to pi of I plus 1 minus 1 and it should be the best answer. But we are assuming that it is not the answer. So, here comes the contradiction that pi of I plus 1 can never be greater than pi of I plus 1. Now, the complexity is further reduced to O of n square because in one step the prefix function can grow at most by one value. So, if the length of the string is n, then it can grow at most n steps. And if it can grow at most n steps, then similarly it can reduce also only n steps because the prefix value cannot be less than 0. So, the total number of string comparisons which we now have to do has become O of n and the net complexity becomes O of n square. Now, we will extending this idea for the final algorithm and we will be also checking this optimization too. Now, extending the idea. So, what we are doing now is we first try extending the suffix of length j is equal to pi of I by checking if s of j is equal to s of I plus 1. इसका क्या मतलब है कि suppose हमने मान लिया कि j बराबर है pi of I के, तो यहाँ पे अगर j is equal to 3 है, इसका मतलब s of I minus 2, s of I minus 1, s of I, ये बराबर होगा s of 0, s of 1 और s of 2 के, तो ये दोनों string बराबर है. तो जब हम pi of I plus 1 calculate करेंगे, तो हम s of 3 को compare करेंगे s of I plus 1 से, अगर वो equal हुआ, तो हम बोल देंगे pi of I plus 1 is equal to pi of I plus 1, that is 3 plus 1 which is equal to 4. But उसकी condition ये है कि s of 3 equal होना चाहिए s of I plus 1 के. और s of 3 क्या है? यहाँ 3 index है और 3 value है pi of I की. तो basically s of pi of I को equal होना चाहिए s of I plus 1 से. तब ऐसा हो सकता है. पर अगर ये equal ना हो, तो फिर हम क्या करेंगे? Now, the next step is, we will find the next longest possible j, such that the prefix of length j is equal to suffix of length j. Suppose in this case j is equal to 2, that is s of I minus 1, s of I, this string is equal to s of 0, s of 1. Now, the next step will be, we will compare s of I plus 1 with s of 2, that is s of I plus 1 with s of j, and check whether they are equal or not. If they are equal, then pi of I plus 1 will be assigned j plus 1, because the length which such that suffix and prefix are equal will be equal to 3. But if this j doesn't work, that is s of 2 will not be equal to s of I plus 1, then we will find the next j again, and we will repeat this step until we get j is equal to 0. Now if j is equal to 0, then we will compare s of 0 with s of I plus 1. If they are equal, then pi of I plus 1 is equal to 1, otherwise it is 0. Now the only question left is, how do we effectively calculate all possible j? So we are making a statement here that the next j, that is the best possible k which is less than j, such that the prefix of length k is equal to suffix of length k and is maximum possible, is equal to pi of j minus 1. So here comes the proof. So suppose humne maan liya, is case mein hi string 1 hai s0, s1, s2 aur s3, aur string 2 hai si minus 3, si minus 2, si minus 1 aur s of I. तो यहाँ पे हम क्लियरली देख सकते हैं कि पाई ऑफ आई की वैल्यू 4 है, तो वही हमारा जे है अभी करेंटली. अब हमें एक के फाइंड करना है सच दैट के की वैल्यू लेस देन हो जे से, और के लॉन्गेस्ट वैल्यू पॉसिबल है सच दैट की प्रीफिक्स बराबर हो सफिक्स के. नाउ क्योंकि स्ट्रिंग 1 और स्ट्रिंग 2 इक्वल है, तो सफिक्स ऑफ स्ट्रिंग 2 बराबर होगा सफिक्स ऑफ स्ट्रिंग 1 के, और हमें फाइनली क्या फाइंड करना है कि सफिक्स ऑफ स्ट्रिंग 2 बराबर हो प्रीफिक्स ऑफ स्ट्रिंग 1 के. तो यहां से हम ये बता बोल सकते हैं कि प्रीफिक्स ऑफ स्ट्रिंग 1 को बराबर होना चाहिए प्रीफिक्स सफिक्स ऑफ स्ट्रिंग 1 के, और हमें एक ऐसा मैक्सिमम वैल्यू k फाइंड करना है. तो व्हाट इज दिस? इट इज नन अदर देन द पाई ऑफ 3, बिकॉज पाई ऑफ 3 इज द मैक्सिमम लेंथ पॉसिबल सच दैट द प्रीफिक्स ऑफ दैट लेंथ इज इक्वल टू द सफिक्स ऑफ दैट लेंथ. And what is pi of 3? It is pi of j minus 1. Now here comes the implementation part. So this is the prefix function and it is taking string as an argument. Now n is the length of the string and pi is the vector for the prefix function. Now we are iterating from 1 to n minus 1, and we are assigning j initially pi of I minus 1 as proved before. Now till j is greater than 0 as well as s of I not equal to s of j, in that case we are assigning j is equal to pi of j minus 1, and if suppose s of I has become equal to s of j, then we have find that value and we will just increase j by 1 and we will assign pi of I is equal to j, and finally we will return this pi vector, which will be our final answer. Now comes the applications of prefix function. The most famous application is KMP algorithm. The problem statement is same as Robin Karp algorithm, which is given a text T and a string S. We want to find and display the position of all occurrences of the string S in the text T. Now we will be using prefix function to calculate this. Now what is the approach? We will generate a string S plus hash plus T. Now hash can be any character which is not present in the string S as well as the string T. So we will make a new string and we will further find prefix function of this new string. Now we can observe that the prefix function value, that is pi of I of this new string, can never exceed the length of the string S, because if it is greater than string S length, then it has to contain hash as the prefix value. So there must be an index such that hash is also coming in a string S and string T, but we have assumed first that hash is not present in string S and string T, so the length of the, basically the value of the prefix function can't exceed the length of the string S. Now suppose if pi of I is equal to n, where n is the length of the string s, then what does it mean? It means that the suffix is equal to the prefix which is of length n. And what is the prefix of length n? It is nothing other than the string s. It means we have find a suffix such that it is equal to the string s. And this we have to find finally. So, for that I, we can say that the substring which ends at that I is equal to the string s. Or we will then find the starting index of that substring, and which will be equal to I minus n plus 1 minus n plus 1, that is I minus 2n in the string p. This can easily be found, you can check it yourself. Now, the total time complexity is equal to O of sum of the length of the two strings. Also, we can observe that the memory used is the same. But we can optimize this memory usage to O of length of the string s. Because here, we can observe that pi of I can't exceed n. So, if we are calculating prefix function till length n, that is till the string s, it will be fine. And to find our final answer, that is the index at which the string s is equal to the substring in t, we can just iterate over the indexes t and check whether its prefix function is equal to n or not. We don't have to store the value of the prefix function at any index in the text t. So the memory usage can be only O of length of the string s. The implementation part, this KMP algo is returning a vector which contains the indexes of starting index of occurrence of the string s in the string text. So n is the length of the string and m is the length of the text in which we have to find the string. Finally, we are making a string str equal to s plus hash plus text. This is the pi vector which contains the prefix function of the whole string. This prefix function we will use of above algorithm which we have find. Now, for length n plus 1 to n plus n, basically for all the indexes of text t, we will find the pi of I. If pi of I is equal to n, that is it is equal to the length of the string s, then we can say that the substring which ends at index I is equal to the string s, and we will push the starting index, that is I minus 2 into n of the text t, which you can see it here. And finally, we will return the answer. What is the answer? Answer is the vector which contains all the starting index of occurrence of string s in the text t. So this was the KMP algorithm. Now there are further applications which include the number of different substring in a string, compressing a string, counting the number of occurrences of each prefix. Now here comes the practice problems. So we have completed with our video. Hope so you have enjoyed it. But your task is not over yet. You have to practice as many problems as you can. So thank you.